Oliveira looks to be really struggling now. He didn't react initially to the first accelerations last time on the climb. Whether he's pacing himself or whether he's struggling, but Vaklund, he's looking good.
We saw Abrahamsson get dropped twice the first time up the climb, and he fought his way back. It's a very different scenario the last time with the stage victory on the line.
Well, at this point in time, you're holding nothing back throughout this climb. The riders are going to know where the steeper section is. They need to keep some energy in reserve for the steeper section. If you blow or if you go too far into the red early on, you'll come to complete stop there.
11 years in the Tour de France for Akaya B&B, and they are yet to win a stage. We talk about droughts in professional cycling. There was a drought for Cofidis. Well, there can't be a drought when you haven't had anything to drink anyway. They're just looking for their first sip of champagne.
Vaklund looking strong here, sitting in his saddle, riding a good rhythm. The gradient's about to back away for a few hundred metres before it really kicks up again.
Back in the team car, it's your old teammate, Sebastian Hinault, who's calling the shots for Arkea B&B. And he is stretching the margin. Abrahamsson still has him within his sights, but there's still plenty of climbing to go.
Will they learn anything about the young Norwegian Jonas Abrahamsson over the past 48 hours? He is a rider who does not give up. Abrahamsson, even if he loses sight of Vaklund, he's gonna push all the way to the top. Matt, here's where it gets really steep.
There's into the red zone, and then there's into the potential Tour de France stage winning zone. That's the region that Kevin Vaklund is in. Less than a kilometre left to climb, and then he plummets down to the finish line in Bologna.
He's riding a nice high cadence. He's spinning his legs quite fast. He's looking good, staying on top of the gear, staying seated.
Gradient of 20%. On Abrahamsson, the gap, we don't have a time check on it, but it's big.
Yeah, the gap is really blowing out now between Abrahamsson and Oliveira. Abrahamsson looks like he's starting to weave his way across the road. Completely different pedaling.
The top of the climb, he can see the arch. He's not worried about the points for the polka dots. It's the 44-second time gap that he's got over Abrahamsson. Vaklund is on the brink of making a childhood dream come true. Then there's a gap to the best of the rest. Pogacar pounces, Vingegaard responds. The first shots have been fired in this year's Tour de France. Not surprisingly, it's the Pog who pulled the trigger.
Well, Pog waited until they near the summit of this climb before he opened up his legs. He stretched the advantage now. Vingegaard chasing desperately on the wheel.
Jonas, how's the training camp been going? Just fine, thanks.
Pogacar, quick glance over his shoulder to see the damage.
For the last 4 years, they've been going head to head. Pogacar with two victories, Vingegaard with two victories. The battle resumes. Who gets a third this year? They're head and shoulders above the rest already.
Vingegaard not giving up a centimetre on the wheel of Tadej Pogacar. Flick of the elbow for Pogacar. Vingegaard shakes his head.
We've seen a lot of grimacing across his face throughout the last 20 kilometres. That is all about to turn to an enormous smile. The biggest moment in his young career.
Huge moment here for Arkea B&B Hotels. Kevin Vaklund, he did everything right. They placed two riders in the breakaway of the day and they followed all the moves. Kevin Vaklund just had the best legs out there.
It was a tactical masterstroke, backed up with brilliant legs. The Tifosi are banging the hoardings as Kevin wants a little bit more. Arkea B&B riding the Tour de France for the 11th time. The wait is finally over. This is their first ever stage victory. Vakala is victorious. Bologna is his new favourite town. The story from the breakaway the last 2 days, sure he hasn't won a stage, but he's won so many hearts. Jonas Abrahamsson, second. The sprint for third, Pascher in front, Rodriguez is challenging, Harada around the outside, who gets third? Pascher, perhaps in a photo, will wait for confirmation. Now the race for the yellow jersey. Is this Remco on his way? It is. He's coming with Carapaz. Remco is putting himself in contention long-term for this Tour de France.
Well, now we can see why Tadej Pogačar and Jonas Vingegaard are working so hard. They want to keep Remco Evenepoel out of contention. Richard Carapaz here on the wheel. Less than 1 kilometre to go.
The flick of the elbow, the yellow jersey awaits, but it's the final one that they're fighting for. Remco is in the mix. So too, Carapaz, Turnison across the line, Hugo Hooler. We await the arrival of Pogačar, Vingegaard, Evenepoel, and Carapaz. No time bonuses up for grabs. It's just the time gains on their rivals. Remco is coming. Pogačar, he wants a few seconds. A lot of effort has been made. Remco, he's looking so good. Carapaz sits on his wheel. The gap has almost closed. 300 metres to go. The time trial world champion, Remco, so often goes on a rampage with long-range attacks. This has been about getting himself back into contention. Carapaz now goes. And Pogačar wants to make sure a small gap doesn't open up. Carapaz leads him through. And now the yellow jersey, 15 seconds. That was the gap that Romain Bardet had at the start of the day. Ciccone is coming towards the line. The clock will stop for Bardet when Ciccone gets there. We'll wait to see where the yellow jersey goes.
It's going to be so tight.